guys, I've been wanting to make this video for like the past week or so, but man, it's so hot right now making videos inside. So I decided to do it today, finally, even though I'm like dying in here, but the fish must love it. So I want to tell you about the 5 amazing facts about cichlids. All cichlids, mostly Africans, but most cichlids. Yeah, I got content for days, but I'll keep it short to 5 facts.
5.
I still don't have like a selfie stick or a tripod, so you know, I'll try to do it however I can do it. So right behind me is my awesome African cichlid aquarium, Tanganyika. So let's begin. I actually took notes this time. So what's so amazing about our dear friends the cichlids? Now, I'm not sure if this applies to all cichlids all over the place, but African cichlids are really smart. They have the mental age of a 5 to 7-year-old. You know what that means? They're smarter than most of your toddlers. Oh yeah. And they can actually learn tricks. You can teach them like to go through a little thing and go for food if you want to hand feed them, if you want to like caress them, not too much because of the slime coat, but if you want to play around with your fish, like I started hand feeding these guys, and yeah, not just yet, hold on, I'm trying to show it, there you go. But they're learning, they're progressively learning. That's why my sand sifters are always at the top, because that's where I feed them. Also my discus, which are, hey, good thing my chair is turning. See my discus right in the back? Them too, I can't hand feed them. So I guess discus are quite as smart. My fact was about African cichlids, that they're 5 to 7-year-olds. But maybe discus are quite around that block too. So what else is amazing about cichlids? Mostly all the cichlids all over the world, Africa, Amazon, Australia, wherever you find cichlids, they're amazing parents. Sometimes they'll be like a family, male and female will take care of them, and sometimes it's just gonna be a female, as in a lot of Malawi cichlids, the female is a mouth brewer. That means she keeps her eggs inside for like 28 days or so, and then she still takes care of the fish after they're born, until like they're grown up enough to fend for themselves. So that's what's awesome about them. And also right behind me I have another great example of African cichlid love of the family. If you ever heard of Bricardes or daffodils, those are Tanganyikan cichlids, rock dwellers. These guys are more amazing than you can imagine. One family will have several generations all live together, and all the new babies and older ones, they all take care of each other. Like if there's a new batch, all the older siblings, even the juveniles, they'll still all take care of the new batch. And I will show you right here. I hope I can show you properly. Right here I have my colony of daffodils, and those tiny little sperm drops are their babies. And you'll see right there, you got some juveniles, and right in there, I got a shell dweller living, and they're always constantly bugging him because they're too scared that he's gonna go and eat the little tiny sperm drops. So this little juvenile fish is actually patrolling. I don't know if you can see it right there. He's patrolling the new batch, and then you have another little sibling. And they're all super tiny still, but they're protecting all the new batch of babies. So how great is that? Now, as for shell dwellers, which I have right in the back. Hold on. Maybe if I do it like that. Shell dwellers, right there, in the shells. These guys will actually breed in the shells and have their babies in the shells. And the male will take care of several females at the time and protect them from the outside, as the female protects the shell from the inside. And now, here below, we have some, I don't know if you can see them, the striped black and white ones. Them too, they're also a little bit like the Bricardes. Male and female and juveniles will take care of their babies for a little while. So they're all like, they make basically a colony of themselves and protect each other. They're freaking awesome, aren't they? So I know a lot of people love like Malawi fish, but I love Tanganyikans, because Tanganyikans do stuff that Malawi fish won't do, like take care of their babies, all of them. So, what's next? So if you love your cichlids, you're gonna love them for a long time. Fact number three, they live from 5 to 6 years. Now, not all of them, but at least in the wild, 5 to 60 years they're gonna live. So that's a long, long time to have your cichlids. So you better take care of them. In captivity, a lot of them will die way before that because clearly we'll mess up at some point and we're gonna kill them. But if you're like super diligent, you never have a power outage, never crash your tank, they could live to 6 years old. I mean, mostly the big ones, you know, like we're not talking about a yellow lab living to 60, maybe 10-year-old. Yeah, he'll make it to 10 if you take care of them. But like Frentosas, definitely, I know they live to 30 years old. These guys right there behind me. So fact number four. Fact number four, there are so many types of cichlids. There are so far 1,600 of them known to scientists, but they believe there's about like 3,000. So there's a lot of undiscovered fish so far in this beautiful world. So that was fact number four. There's a lot of them. I think it's one of the biggest families. I'm not sure, Google that, but pretty sure. Oh yeah, fact number five. Now, it doesn't matter what size of tank you have because cichlids can be from 1 inch to 3 feet. 3 feet long. Well, that's the emperor cichlid. But if you have a small tank, like a 10 gallon, you can keep shell dwellers. These guys that go in the shells, right there. I hope you can see it well. I'm trying to like multi-filmlets. So these were your amazing five facts about cichlids. Five amazing facts. So if you love my spinning little video, give me a thumbs up, yeah. And subscribe if you want to see more of this. All right, see you soon, guys. Bye-bye.